It's news time. Information is power. Be current. The news headline. Biafra National Guard announces when Biafra pounds will become in use. The Biafra National Guard fighters looted a shop and filling station in Abia State on Thursday. They also ordered and declared that the sovereignty of the Southeast will take effect on October 30. The officer, General Innocent Oji, expressed that the association is battle ready, that Biafra is real, and every of the Biafran members should sit at home, saying that the Biafra pounds will still be in use very soon. The investigative journalist was reacting to the alleged statement credited to Nnamdi Kanu's brother, which says that BNG, that is the Biafra National Guard, is a DSS-sponsored organization. He said that they encountered Biafra national members and Nigerian troops had yesterday proven Kanu's brother wrong. Ifeanyi, however, urged everyone that desire to restore the defunct nation of Biafra to come home, adding that General Innocent Oji is already leading from the front line. He said, Nnamdi Kanu's brother yesterday said, BNG is a DSS agency, that yesterday Nigerian troops and Biafran National Guard battled almost for the whole day. BNG lost one personnel, while headcounts of Nigerian loss is yet to be made public by Nigerian soldiers. BNG will make public the loss of Nigerian army and details of the success of the battle. Kanu's brother has been proven wrong by this development. Time is ticking. One casualty is a success compared to open battle with Nigerian troops with all they have, jets and all. The Biafra National Guard has come to stay. Somebody should tell Kanu's brother that business is over. Anybody that wanna talk about Biafra must come home and fight. General Oji is leading from the front line. He is not at home giving orders. I salute courageous men of the Biafran Army. President Muhammadu Buhari said his Turkish counterparts have set an example to the rest of the world on how to treat refugees. I commend Your Excellency for leadership and generosity in receiving and accommodating 4 million refugees fleeing from conflict areas, particularly in Iraq, Syria, and Afghanistan. You have indeed set an example to the rest of the world, the Nigerian leader said. President Muhammadu Buhari described the 2 days visit of President Erdogan and the First Lady Emini Erdogan as a reflection of the robust, warm, and cordial bilateral relation between Nigeria and Turkey. He noted that it was the second time he has had the pleasure of receiving many brothers in Abuja. On the accomplishments from the visit, President Muhammadu Buhari said, during the visit, we held very useful discussions on a number of bilateral issues aimed at discussing germane matters and strengthening the cordial relationship between Nigeria and Turkey. The key issues we touched on included a series of bilateral agreements and memoranda of understanding that had been finalized. As a positive outcome, either major agreements, MOUs, on a number of the key sectors, including energy, defense industry, mining, and hydrocarbons, among others, were signed today. We have agreed that implementation is to commence immediately. In the course of our discussions, we also reviewed the travel ban list based on the revised COVID-19 protocols and removed Turkey from Nigeria's travel ban list. Turkey has indeed achieved remarkable success in addressing the COVID-19 pandemic. President Muhammadu Buhari said President Erdogan's meeting with a joint session of the Nigeria and Turkish Chambers of Commerce and Industry before departing Nigeria would actually be an opportunity to engage and exchange views on more productive ways of pushing ahead the socio-economic ties between the two countries. He thanked the Turkish President and First Lady for commissioning the Turkish Cultural Center in Abuja, as well as opening the newly renovated government secondary school in Wuse, Abuja, undertaken by the Turkish Cooperation and Coordination Agency, SICA. In his remarks, President Erdogan stressed that Turkey was determined to improve relations with Nigeria to higher levels on the field, where President Muhammadu Buhari had actually hosted the President Recep Tayyip Erdogan of the Republic of Turkey in a two-day official visit to Nigeria. President Erdogan also said that the trade volume between both countries reached $2 billion in 2020, making Nigeria the outstanding and biggest trading partner in sub-Saharan Africa. However, we still believe that this level of trade we have achieved is far from being adequate. We hope and pray that we will be expanding our trade volume up to $5 billion immediately. We hope that the relations between the two nations will be further developed on the basis of a win-win scenario and mutual respect. The president, who spoke through an interpreter, said, commiserating with Nigeria on the attack in Goronyo, local government area of Sokoto State, which claimed several lives, the Turkish leader pledged that his country would further cooperate with Nigeria on counter-terrorism as well as in fields of military defense and security. We are ready to share our over-expanding capabilities with Nigeria, especially in the field of defense, industry, and security, which has been praised by the entire globe. This sensitivity that we have showcased in fighting terrorism, I hope, will be reciprocated by our Nigerian brothers and sisters and counterparts, he said. The Turkish president announced that his country has increased its diplomatic presence in Africa to 43 missions, adding that the third round of the Turkish African Business Forum will be held in Istanbul this October, while the third Turkish African Partnership Summit will follow in December. President Erdogan expressed delight that many Nigerian students are currently studying in Turkey and benefiting from scholarship as well. And this is President Recep Tayyip of Turkey, after the President Muhammadu Buhari of our own country had actually signed some bilateral agreement with them. And, the President was actually commending President Muhammadu Buhari for his generosity and also receiving him and also accommodating 4 million refugees that fled from Iraq, Syria, and Afghanistan, saying that he has set an example to the rest of the world, where the president described the 2 days visit as a time to reflect and then on robust, warm, and cordial bilateral relation between Turkey and Nigeria, where he noted that in terms of MOUs, defense industry, because the 8 major keys that I actually discussed about was rallying about energy, defense industry, mining, hydrocarbons, among others, and they signed the hood and they signed them, in the bid to ensure that there is further cordial relationship between the two countries. In the course of their discussions, the President Muhammadu Buhari also stated that they had removed Turkey from Nigeria's ban list, saying that Turkey has actually achieved a remarkable success in addressing COVID-19 pandemic. Thanks for listening.